are going to be making absolutely stunning arch bookshelf. Hi guys, welcome to If Only April. I'm April and today we'll be doing an exciting project. I'm currently in the process of renovating my kid's small playroom, and if you've been here last week, I did this amazing Trofast unit hack, you know, like that where I combined two units and put the doors on it and made it into some fabulous piece of furniture. Check it out if you haven't yet. This week we're gonna be tackling the book situation, and basically I'm gonna be making this absolutely stunning bookshelf. To be completely honest, I had like a really hard time to naming this project. It also can be a book display, it has ledgers, but for the purpose of making things easier, let's just call it the arched bookshelf. No matter what you call it, it just looks amazing! In our previous play space, we had these four book ledgers that I also built like a couple of years ago, and they worked really great till one moment, everything changed. I saw a video on YouTube of this absolutely amazing magazine stand that DIY Danie made. As she would say, that Pinterest made her do it, DIY Danie made me do it. The moment I saw that bookshelf, I felt that I absolutely have to make one for myself. I mean, for the kids, of course. So I decided to make mine wider than Danie's. I'm not sure how tall is hers, but I kind of feel that mine is still taller than her magazine stand. Mine not gonna be holding magazines, it's just gonna be holding books for the playroom. But let's get to building it! So exciting! Since the plywood sheet that you need is quite large, you'll need to ask your home department store to cut it to length. You can choose any length and width that you want, just make sure to measure your car before you go, to avoid a situation where you stand in the parking lot confused about how to fill the whole thing inside. Yes. It did happen to me before. It's not fun. So this was one of those cases when the size of the car basically determined the size of my project, because if I could fit like a bigger plywood sheet into my car, I would totally go for the bigger bookshelf. After I measured my car, I decided to make this book display 40 by 80 inches. So when the plywood sheet was finally home and I started cutting the arch. A few months ago, I already made half an arch for my pegboard room divider that you can actually see in the back. So when I made this room divider, I used this thread to basically trace a circle and cut it. The thing is, it didn't come out as perfect as I wanted, and yes, there is no limit to perfection, right? So this time around, I decided to make an absolutely perfect round for this arch. I took scrap wood and measured the distance from the center of the board to the edge. Then I drilled a small hole on the scrap board at exactly halfway distance, and I put a nail loosely in the center. This way, the pencil could trace a perfect half circle without wiggling off. Then I took a jigsaw and cut the half arch. Try to go as slow as possible with the jigsaw to make sure it's staying on track, but other than that, it's super simple. So the arch is ready and the arch is cut out, and now we're gonna sand it. I mean, you know how I feel about sanding, but yeah, let's do it! When the arch was ready, we had to determine where we want the shelves to be. So here's the thing, if you're using it for the books for the kids, I highly recommend to take like a largest, tallest book that you have and basically use it as a template to see the distance between the shelves. Then we need to decide where the shelves will go. Place 1x3s on the arch and decide on how long you want the shelves to be. I measured 2 inches from both sides, which brought me to 36 inches wide shelves. Then you need to decide how large of the spacing you want for the shelves. If you're making this arch book display for kids, then take the tallest book that you have. I mean, of course, assuming that this is not the only largest book that you have, and use it as a spacer. The spacing between our DIY bookshelf is about 14 inches. It basically gives enough space for the books to wiggle and yeah, not to be too cramped inside. When you know all the numbers, cut the boards to size. Use glue and bread nailer to attach the hobby boards to 1x3s. The nail gun in this case acts as a bonding effect for the glue to start doing its magic. Obviously don't skip the glue, like I did once when I was making this farm veggie stand, and I've learned my lesson since then. No one is too cool for the glue. That's a fun story actually, I'm gonna leave you the link to watch it. Leave the glue to cure and fill the tiny holes with a wood filler so they're not visible when you paint it. If you're planning to stain it, use a wood filler that can be covered with a stain. Okay, and now comes the most fun part, to paint it. I'll talk more about like color choices when I'm gonna be making my full playroom makeover video, but for now I'm just gonna tell you that I chose a Dandelion Wish by Bear for the yellow color of their arch and Vanilla Paste by Bear for the shelves. I think they go so well together. I used samples for both of them and was very confident that the sample would be enough to paint the arch. Unfortunately, I didn't have the right roller in the beginning and I felt that I could swing it with a big roller for the walls. Well, not so fast. Most of the paint was soaked into the big roller till I was forced to go out to my local hardware store and get a smaller roller. I could have used the brush, but you know what? I mean, good ideas always come later, right? It took me longer than expected to paint this arch and I almost ran out of the paint sampler, but if you'll attempt to make the same one, just use the right size roller from the start or use the brush and the paint sampler will be more than enough for the arch. Noted for the future. While the paint on the arch was drying, I painted shelves, or you can also call them ledgers if you think about it, right? This unit has so many names, like literally. I applied two coats and if you want a smooth finish, make sure you sand in between coats. When it was all painted, we had to assemble this shelf. And let me show you, it's actually so much easier than it seems. To assemble this bookcase, you'll need clamps, screws and wood glue. Remember, we already measured where the shelves will go, so it was easy to place them. And then drill four holes throughout on the places where the shelves will be. Then I added wood glue to the shelves and clamped it to the arch plywood back. After that, I flipped the whole thing over and drove screws through the previously pre-drilled holes. Easy peasy! Clamps in this case are your best friend. And let me show you, these ones are my absolute favorite. They're clamps by Irvin and I'm gonna leave you the link below because they just work magic. Ta-da! And the bookshelf was ready! After a bit of suffering, I brought it from the garage to the playroom and that was time to attach it to the wall because since you remember, I'm making it for the kids, but since it was made for the kids, I couldn't just lean it against the wall like Danie did with her magazine stand because, well, for obvious reasons, because kids are like little monkeys, you know, they're gonna just climb it and yeah, the whole thing gonna collapse on them. Not a good scenario. Nope. So make sure to attach the whole structure to the wall and here we have few options. Number one is to find the studs and drill the screws through the studs, but in this case it's going to be visible on the outside and I mean it could be still covered by books, but if you want to make it look perfect, then you can use the French clip. And here I want to give a massive shout out to Danie and thank you so much for responding to my Instagram message. I asked you like what would be the best way to attach this whole structure that she so beautifully designed to the wall. And she told me French clips and was like, ta-da! Brilliant idea. I don't know how I didn't think about it before. What are French clips, are you gonna ask me? A French clip is a way of securing a cabinet, mirror, artwork or another object to the wall. It is molding with a 30 to 45 degree slope used to hang cabinets or other objects. French clips can be used in pairs or use a clip mounted to the wall and a matching edge cut into the object to be hung. Courtesy of Wikipedia. Basically need two boards cut at 45 degree bevel cut. And one will be attached to the wall and another one will be attached to the bookshelf. When they both are secured, you hang the bookshelf to the board on the wall. You can buy the metal ones on the store and I'm gonna leave you the link below for those or you can make it yourself. And guess which one I chose? So how to make the French clips from plywood? I think that if you choose 3/4 plywood, it will have a stronger connection, but I decided to use 1/2 inch plywood since I didn't want it to be bulky and too visible on the wall. Adjust the blade on your table saw to 45 degrees and rip the plywood sheet in half. Both of my boards are approximately 8 inches wide. I guess I could go for a smaller width, but I thought it's gonna be more secure if I'm gonna make it wider. I mean, I'm not sure about that. When you have two boards, attach one to the bookshelf and another one to the wall. Find the studs on the wall to make sure you're not driving your screws into the hollow. And always level at every step of the way, this is super important, to make sure it's not skewed. So in the end, basically, if this is the cleat on the wall, you're basically gonna kind of slide on the shelf. Let me show you how it's done. When you attach both boards, take the bookcase and hang it on the board on the wall. Well, it worked like a charm. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you're new here, please subscribe and follow my journey on how I renovate my playroom. So I'm still debating if I should leave this arch the way it is, or I should add the bookcase maybe on like nice golden legs on the bottom so I could stack more books into it, because I still need more storage for my books. But yes, guys, what do you think about this arch? Leave me the comment below. I would love to hear your thoughts. And yes, I'll see you next week. Bye. Display, bookshelf, mounted wall shelves, book ledgers. Hard, very hard to choose.